Welcome back to the channel Living in the Philippines. This is the 12th video of playlists of cities to visit in Philippines, and it's all about Manila, the capital of the Philippines. Manila is the gateway for almost all travelers to the Philippines. This is where you will take your first step in the Philippine territory. Manila's treasures are revealed only to those who take time to visit it. Often criticized, the capital of Philippines does not have a good reputation because of the pollution, slums, and traffic jams. But Manila is far from being limited to just that. Manila has history and historic center worthy of interest. The history of the city is fascinating and tragic. Let's take a walk behind the walls of the old city and in order to illustrate the capital of the Philippines. Manila was once called the Pearl of Asia. The charm of its streets and churches reminiscent of distant Spain. When World War II broke out, the Philippines was under American protectorate, and Japan invaded the islands in 1942. In 1945, when the capture of Manila was unnecessary, the two sides fought a bloody battle, the Battle of Manila. The result? A destroyed city, martyrs of the Second World War. A very sad fate, but which still leaves the traveler some traces of its splendid past, and even small jewels still standing. Intramuros. In the heart of Manila, in the middle of its immense boulevard and its mud effervescence, Intramuros district emerges like a bubble of oxygen, an oasis of tranquility. It is the oldest district of the capital, built in 16th century and surrounded by ramparts. It formerly concentrated the entire agglomeration of the city on 64 hectares. Its Hispanic atmosphere is still there, mixed with medieval decor. Intramuros was built following the basics of Western fortresses. Today, the covered way is an invitation to stroll and offers pretty points of view. The prison cells are now cafes and restaurants. The moat has been filled in and turned into gardens and golf course. Once you pass one of the imposing gates that give access to the Intramuros, you find yourself in another town. Behind the imposing stone walls and bastions, hide small alleys restored with care in testimony of the colonial past, where the calesa drawn by horses are still used. San Agustin Church, located inside the historic district of Intramuros, is a Baroque church classified as World Heritage by UNESCO since 1993. It is the only building that remained intact after the destruction of Intramuros during World War II. Built between 1587 and 1606, it is the oldest church in the Philippines. The massive facade contrasts with the richly decored interior filled with objects and great historical and cultural value. The current structure is the third to stand at this site and has withstood 7 major earthquakes as well as the Battle of Manila. It is an active and popular church for weddings and other ceremonies. Access is through San Agustin Museum, which contains a treasure trove of antiques giving a glimpse of fabulous riches of ancient Manila, including the ivory statue of Immaculate Conception. The entrance fee is 200 pesos. Casa Manila. Located opposite of San Agustin Church, Casa Manila is a superb reproduction of a Spanish colonial house testifying to the great wealth of the city bourgeoisie in 19th century. The imposing stone and wood structure is full of luxurious element. If the house is a recreation, the furniture and artwork are genuine antiques. The entrance fee is 75 pesos. Memorial Manila. Located in small shaded park, this memorial pays homage to 150,000 Manila people who perished in the Battle of Manila. Nearby, signs show photos of the city before and after the battle. Manila Cathedral. The full name of Manila Cathedral is Minor Basilica and Metropolitan Cathedral of Immaculate Conception. This cathedral is dedicated to the Virgin Mary as Our Lady of the Immaculate Conception. Manila Cathedral has been destroyed 7 times since it was first founded in 1571. The current building dates from 1958. Inside, you can admire a gilded altar, an organ with 4,500 pipes and superb stained glass rose windows. The friezes that adorn the bronze door describe the tragic events that lead to the destruction of the cathedral. The last renovation were completed in 2014 after 2 years of work, where the audio, video, and lighting systems were brought up to date and provide an optimal experience. Fort Santiago. Located at the mouth of Pasig River, the fort is one of Manila's significant historical sites. several heroes of the national history of Philippines knew its prison and lost their lives there during the Spanish colonial period and Second World War. Jose Rizal, poet, novelist, and artist who played a major role in emancipation of the Filipino people from Spanish colonization, was imprisoned there before his execution in December 1896. The Rizal Shrine Museum features Rizal Shrine memorabilia and copper imprints embedded in the pavement commemorating his last steps from his cell to the place of his execution. Partially rebuilt after World War II, the fort has become a place for walking, with well-kept gardens, plaza, fountains, and a bee-in. You can climb the medieval ramparts, which offer a beautiful view of Manila. The entrance fee is 100 pesos and the entrance to Rizal Museum is included. National Museum. Located very close to Rizal Park and Intramuros District, the National Museum is the main museum in the Philippines. It manages the National Museum of Fine Arts, the National Museum of Anthropology, the National Museum of Natural History, and the National Planetarium, all located within National Museum Complex in Manila. Free entry. The National Museum of Fine Arts, formerly known as the National Art Gallery. This remarkable museum houses a collection of paintings and sculptures by Filipino artists, including the Spolarium and the Parisian Life of Juan Luna. The National Museum of Anthropology, formerly known as the Museum of the Philippine People. This museum houses the section of anthropology and archaeology. It is located in the old Philippine Ministry of Finance building opposite to the main building of the National Museum. It is a place to learn about the cultural history of Manila, which makes the city what it is today, and the building of the Philippine archipelago. Rizal Park. Located south of Intramuros, Rizal Park is more widely known as Luneta due to its small moon shape. This 60-hectare park loans, ornamental gardens, ponds, paved paths, and wooded areas is dotted with monuments dedicated to the Filipino heroes. This is the place where Jose Rizal was executed in December 1896, or stands the monument to Rizal, which contains the remains of the hero. At the end of the park, after National Museum, there is a small artificial lake, within its center, a miniature reconstruction of the Philippine archipelago. The park is a place of relaxation for the Manila residents as well as visitors. In the evening, the musical dancing fountain comes alive with colorful jets and all kinds of outdoor concerts take place in auditorium. Manila Bay is a natural port from which Philippines has built a whole network of commercial lines centered on the port of Manila. It is for the reason that over the centuries, the bay has played a vital role in the city's growth and success. Beyond the harbor is Rojas Boulevard, which has been renovated and is now known as the Bay Walk. It is a very popular place where locals and tourists meet. It is also a perfect place for a relaxing walk. The best time to visit Manila Bay is in the late afternoon as the sun sets. A man-made white sand beach was inaugurated in September, north of the Bay Walk. If you travel the beautiful country of the Philippines, you will have to pass through Manila for a short stopover most of the time. If you can afford it, give Manila a chance to have a nice day from it. The place presented, Intramuros, Rizal Park, and the Bay Walk are very close to each other near Malete District. I hope you enjoyed this video. Remember to subscribe and turn the bell on to receive notification of future posts. A big thank you for your support and your encouragement. Don't hesitate to comment on topics that interest you. Take care and see you soon!